Hello, everyone.
Sorry, I forgot to remove my mask.
A few moments later.
Hello, everyone. My name is Farah Hin, and this is JeeShen from Softinn Solution. All right. So in this video, I was informed that you will show us how to set up MyKad Reader.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So first, can you start telling us why this MyKad Reader is important to hotels?
Basically, it's a compliance issue. So every time we check into a hotel room, it is part of the regulations in many countries to register the guest details. You know, if you are a foreign guest, you will have to surrender your passport so that the hotel would get a copy. For Malaysia guests, right, the it is required to register your MyKad. So these are required because there are cases where things happen, and when police visit the hotels, they would need this kind of information from the hotel. So it's for safety purpose, and it's also for compliance purpose.
I see. That's a good information that I heard. So maybe now that we are going to install this MyKad Reader, is there any other tools or thing that we need other than this MyKad Reader?
Okay, when it comes to MyKad, right, there's only one hardware needed for the reading. So there's plenty of MyKad Reader in the market. So if you go to Lazada, you look for Softinn MyKad Reader, you probably find compatible MyKad Reader as well. Regardless of the brand, as long as it is reading my card and it comes with a USB, most of the time it works with Softinn PMS.
So mean that we can just buy online, see the review. If it's okay, then we can just buy from any online platform like Shopee, Lazada.
But our recommended ones are to go to Lazada, look for Softinn compatible MyKad Reader, because those are the MyKad Reader vendors who have tested their reader with our system.
I see. All right. Okay. Then now that we have been informed what the tools needed, maybe right now you can show us how to set up the MyKad Reader.
Sure. Okay. So most of the time, you probably get a MyKad Reader in USB port. So plug in the USB, and very often you don't need to install any driver. It's just plug and play, right? So I am going to launch the Softinn FATboy app on my desktop, on my laptop. So from here, to set up the MyKad Reader, go to setting, log in. So once you log in, right, you will be presented a list of hardware, you know, that works with our kiosk app. So for MyKad Reader, you choose the MyKad Reader here, and then you will be given a list of compatible MyKad readers. Okay, so for most of the USB MyKad reader out there, go for LCOR.
USB, go for LCOR.
Yeah. So once you save the MyKad reader setting, close the app and relaunch it, and you are ready to go.
That sounds simple. Very
straightforward.
Very simple to install.
Yeah, so a lot of my customers thought it required us visiting a hotel to set up. So once we show them a video on how to set up, they were surprised like how easy it is.
Yeah, that's so easy. Then maybe after this, can you show us, after you scan the MyKad, how the information will appear?
Okay, but first I think we need to scan the MyKad. So to scan the MyKad, navigate to the MyKad tab. All right, so let me try with my MyKad. So insert the MyKad with the chip in front to the reader. All right, and click read MyKad. So you will see a loading time, loading indicator that the device is reading the MyKad. So once it's read it, if you notice, there is this button here, copy guest data. Once I click copy guest data, it will be copied to my text. Then, so I am navigating now to our PMS. So assuming that I am going to check in myself to the hotel, I'm going to create a new reservation. Of course, I won't cover the how to create a reservation. You may watch other videos for that. But I'm just going to show how you paste the scan details to the PMS. Click paste guest info. You will see my information being populated. My address, etc., will be populated at the back end as well.
That's going to help a lot of hoteliers and front desk make the check-in process a lot faster if they are not having this one. It's going to take a long time.
The good thing about using this is that, you know, some people will say, like, I could actually type, right? You know, but type, you make mistakes.
True.
Okay, one. Two, when you scan this using the software, a copy of the MyKad reader image will be captured in the laptop. As well, in my laptop as well. So if even if I key in wrongly, I have a image copy of my MyKad. So that's the difference between like typing versus using a software and a device.
So it's gonna prevent a lot of human error, and it also has a backup. Like you still mentioned just now, the image.
Yeah. So you have, when you have most of the hotels put this into their SOP to photo state the MyKad. So with this, you no longer need to photo state. So basically, a copy of the image is saved into your hard disk.
So you save a paper that way also?
Yeah.
That's a good thing to hear. Okay.
Yeah. So if you notice on the app, right, you get to also scan passport, etc. But this video, we're just going to talk about the MyKad reader.
True. This video, we're only going to talk about the MyKad. Let me know if you want us to cover about the passport also, then maybe we can do for another video.
Yeah, maybe for the passport, we can do it at the kiosk.
Yes, true. Alright, so I think now that we have covered how to set up, how to scan, so is there any other thing that we should keep in mind when we are using this MyKad reader?
Okay, so it happens before that. Okay, the MyKad reader read MyKick, MyTantara, as well. So if you know what MyTantara is, it's a ID IC issued to the military personnel.
Okay.
So it works and it's compatible. And then what you need to pay attention is sometimes, you know, MyKad, it has this chip, right?
Yes.
So if this chip is not well cleaned, there's a lot of, you know, as if you notice, mine also a lot of dirt accumulated on the on the chip. So sometimes you just need to rub it a bit before you scan it. Because basically the device is reading from this chip.
Okay, so before we thought like macam the device might be broken itself, maybe we should just clean our chips before we scan the MyKad.
Yeah, so that's the difference, you know, that is what it takes.
Alright, then I think we have covered all things about how to set up, how to scan, and how the information will appear. And I noticed that this software that you open in your laptop here is say FATboy App. So are these FATboy apps free to use?
Yeah, it's free to use for our merchants.
Free to use for our merchant only.
Basically, we don't charge them extra for using the software.
So that means these are only compatible with Softinn PMS?
If you wanted to download the app and try reading a MyKad, you can do so. But the thing is that you can't paste it to your PMS. So it makes no purpose, right? It serves no purpose. And from this app, you get to see the guests arriving, you know, you may issue room key from here and etc.
So it's really worked the best, and you can get a maximum function of this software if you use it together with the Softinn PMS.
Of course.
Alright, I see. I think that's all the things that we have covered in this video. Thanks again, JeeShen, for joining us in this video. I think maybe before I end this video, is there anything else that you want to share with us?
I think no, that's all. I think if you have any other topics that you are interested to know more, feel free to comment below. It took us a while to learn how to shoot video, and what you like, what you don't, do also suggest, you know, it will help us how to, you know, to improve the video.
Yes, correct. I agree on that. So do let us know what you thought in the comment section below. It can be any question, it can be comment, suggestion, or whatever it is. We're gonna read through, and we will make sure that we reply to the comment that you have given to us.
She will reply.
Yeah, I will reply. So I think that's all. So I hope this information will be useful to the viewers out there. And last but not least, don't forget to like this video if you find it useful. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you find if you want more hotel related content in the future. So until we meet again in the next video. Bye.
Bye-bye.
What is the other question?
Sorry, I forgot to remove my mask. You don't need a note. You just go.